When Bitcoin first started, many people from China embraced it, and some of them even became billionaires due to the rise of Bitcoin. Bitcoin quickly gained popularity in China as a way to earn a quick profit. In fact, about 85% of all Bitcoin trading is done with at least one Chinese person, and a staggering 70% of all Bitcoin miners is located in China. This is partially due to their cheap electricity as well as having the cheapest computers for mining. Apart from profits, it was also a way to hide money away from the prying eyes of their government. In view of this, the Chinese government started banning Bitcoin and ICOs back in 2017, wiping out almost 35 billion of the crypto market cap. Now they are back with a more serious agenda, the banning of the Bitcoin mining. So let's explore, why is China banning Bitcoin mining? There are three possible reasons: government control, environmental pollution, and monetary policy. Let's go through them individually. Government control. The Chinese government is known to control many things under their rule. The social credit system is one example of their desire for control, where they plan to monitor every action of their citizens. Therefore, the Chinese government probably doesn't want people hiding things from them, and Bitcoin is no exception. However, Xi Jinping, China's president, is a fan of blockchain, and he even said the new generation of information technology represented by artificial intelligence, quantum information, mobile communication, Internet of Things, and blockchain is accelerating breakthroughs in its range of applications. If China is developing their own blockchain cryptocurrency, it's no wonder they want Bitcoin eradicated in their country, so there's less competition. Having their own cryptocurrency allows them to bring down transaction costs, provides financial services to the more rural areas, and track and monitor money more easily. All of this improves the efficiencies of their monetary policies. Which brings us to the next point, China monetary policy. A monetary policy is how a central bank governs the supply of money and the interest rate of the economy in order to influence GDP, employment, and prices. China aims to control and keep the value of their yuan stable, and Bitcoin is an alternative source of money that could threaten the stability of their yuan, so they want it banned. On the other hand, China welcomes gold. This is because gold is a recognized asset class that is stable and has proven to be a good store of value. Perhaps one day, China is waiting to declare yuan to be fully backed up by gold, making their currency the first gold standard since the 1970s. If they succeed, they will be recognized as a reliable reserve currency against the increasingly debased US dollar, likely as an attempt to become the next global superpower. Environmental pollution.
China is currently the world's largest polluter. Certain provinces are so polluted with smog that you have to wear a mask to breathe properly. China is aggressively trying to change this public perception. But with so much Bitcoin mining in China, it certainly doesn't help its case, because 60% of China's electricity comes from coal-burning plants. Mining rigs are used to mine bitcoins, and they require powerful hardware and consumes electricity like no tomorrow. There's the famous saying, with great power comes great electricity bills. In fact, in a single day, the electricity used for Bitcoin mining in China is enough to power the average American household for over 5 million years. Unfortunately, this problem is only going to get worse. Bitcoin was designed with a cap of 21 million coins, and the more coins mined, the harder and more electricity it consumes to mine. Because electricity makes up about 70% of the cost of mining, miners want the cheapest electricity. And that place is Sichuan, where it has over 1,400 rivers and 3,200 hydro plants that produces cheap hydropower at just 1 cent per kilowatt hour, compared to about 12 cents in US or 16 cents in Singapore. In fact, Bitcoin mining is about 80% powered by renewable energy, which is about 4 times more than the global average of about 20%, making Bitcoin mining much cleaner than most industries. However, hydropower is seasonal. The wet season generates 3 times more electricity than the dry season. Since mining rigs do not turn off during the dry season when hydropower is insufficient, coal-based electricity is used instead. The carbon emission factor of electricity in Sichuan therefore ranges from 265 to 579 grams of carbon dioxide per kilowatt hour, depending on the season. Much higher compared to Sweden with a carbon emission factor of 13 grams of carbon dioxide per kilowatt hour, but it's because Sweden's electricity is fueled mostly by nuclear and hydroelectric power. The electricity cost of mining one Bitcoin in China is about $3,172, one of the lowest in the world. But as the price of Bitcoin crashed, known as the crypto winter, it was crucial to use the latest and most efficient mining rigs in order to be profitable. However, regularly upgrading causes a lot of e-waste, which is an environmental concern. A report finds that the annualized e-waste generation of mining rigs would amount to 10,948 metric tons. That is about 20% of the e-waste generated by a country like Singapore. This brings two benefits to the world. Firstly, lesser environmental pollution, and secondly, reduces the dependence on China for Bitcoin. Bitcoin miners will flock to the next cheapest energy sources, which is often renewable energy. Places like Iceland and Canada have massive amounts of clean renewable energy in the form of hydropower or geothermal. In fact, a Bitcoin mined in China emits 4 times the carbon dioxide than a Canadian mined Bitcoin. Furthermore, majority of the Bitcoin network is in China now, but no party should control more than 50% of the network for safety. This ban would further decentralize it, increasing the confidence in Bitcoin. Although Bitcoin could be the next monetary evolution for societies, governments are being cautious with the risk. The good news is that the underlying technology that powers Bitcoin is evolving, and more efficient cryptocurrency and blockchain solutions are being created rapidly. In the near future, there could be a practical solution that is secure, fast, and energy efficient to use, and we can all start enjoying greater benefits.
This video took many hours to produce and was made possible in part by viewer donations on Patreon. If you want to help us make more videos, you can support us on Patreon. If not, a share goes a long way as well. We look forward to sharing more videos with you guys soon.